Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be doing a fave and fails review update video. And you guys know here on my channel, I do a lot of review videos, but I never really give you an update on products that I have reviewed in the past and if I still like them and how I feel about them after trying them out for like a month, 2 months. So I figured, you know what, let's sit down, let me film a video giving you an update on what I liked, what I didn't like, and how I use these products. So I hope you all enjoy this type of video. If you do, comment down below, like this video, let me know if you'd like to see this maybe every month, every other month, to give you an update. So as always, everything will be linked down below. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And as always, let's dive on in and get started in today's video. The first product that I want to share with you is a product that I actually ended up really liking even after I did my review video, and it is from CoverGirl. It is the Easy Breezy 24-Hour Brow Ink Pen. It's dual end, so it has like a little silicone brush. The other end obviously is our felted point tip pen, and I actually really, really liked it. It's really pigmented, it lasts all day, and I just ended up really liking it. It was really easy to use. This is something that surprised me just because I have tried the Anastasia Beverly Hills and the Tarte Brow Pen, but this one just stood out in its own way. You definitely have a lot of control of how light or dark or how thick or thin you want the little hair-like strokes to be. So this one, I definitely feel like if you haven't tried this out, I highly suggest it. As for a fail for me, this one is the PYT Beauty. This is basically a eyeshadow primer. This is something that I liked at first. I think if you are looking for something just to apply on as a primer on your lid and not do anything like a cut crease and get really creative and fancy, I feel like this will be perfect for you because it does really brighten the pigmentation of the shadows and it does prolong the wear of the eyeshadow on your lids. But in the fact of like if you're trying to do a slight cut crease and do a little bit more, I found it to be really messy. It gets really sticky, especially if you're trying to layer it on over an eyeshadow and do everything. So personally, I was not a huge fan of it, but I did like the packaging. I really love the affordability of it. I love that it's a squeezy tube. It's different. I love that it's slightly pigmented. But just so far, unfortunately for me, it just didn't work out the way I hoped for trying it out after some time. So the next product's from LA Girl, and this is something that I actually really like, but I want to continue testing this out, but I did want to give you an update. So this is the LA Girl Tinted Foundation with a natural finish. This is in the shade of Tawny, and I absolutely love the undertone to it. I love how it blends out really nicely. It has a natural finish for sure. The only thing it is with this foundation is that right now in LA it's really, really hot, and I feel like I get oily pretty quickly when I wear this foundation. I feel like this is perfect if I'm gonna be out for like 4 to 6 hours and then come home and wash my face. But if I'm gonna be out for like 8 to 12 hours, I don't think this is it for me, just because I get really, really oily. I do have combination oily skin, so I think this is perfect for me during the fall winter time when my skin's a little bit more dry, the air is a little bit drier, and I feel like my makeup usually holds up a lot better during the fall winter time. So I'm gonna wait to continue testing this out during that time. I'll give you guys an update, but as you can tell, girl, I have used it up. I'm saving it for the fall winter season, so I'll keep you guys posted. The next product is another product that I ended up really liking, and this one is the Milani Fetish Matte Lipsticks. I still have them all. I absolutely fell in love with the formula. I find it to be very different than anything that I have reviewed here on my channel that I have tried out. And what I love about it is not only the affordability of it, but I love that it, even though it's a matte lipstick, it's not overly drying. It's really creamy. It's very pigmented. It doesn't enhance the fine lines in your lips. It doesn't give you that weird little white rim in the inner lining of your mouth after wearing a certain lipstick for a few hours or for some time. So I really love the formula of it. It's really nice. It's very different, very comfortable on the lips, and it doesn't over dry them, which is a big plus. So if you haven't tried these out, I highly suggest it just because they're that good. The next item is something that I actually didn't review here on my channel, but I did purchase it and test it out behind the scenes. And this is the Milani Make It Last Original Natural Finish Setting Spray. It's supposed to help hold your makeup for 16 hours. It's a prime, correct, and set spray. To be really honest, I don't feel like it prolonged my makeup in any way. If anything, it did help to obviously spray this on my face to like blend everything out together that I've applied on, especially if I over powdered, you know, my face with any banana powder or setting powder or anything like that. But overall, like if I've noticed it extended the wear of my makeup, I don't feel like it did. So unfortunately, this is not something that I can see myself repurchasing. I'll definitely continue using it, but I just don't feel like it's anything different that will make me want to repurchase it. I do love the spray of it. I love the little bottle of it. I feel like it's perfect for travel. It feels comfortably in my hand. I love the scent to it. I just don't feel like it did anything extra. You know what I mean? That to make me justify repurchasing it. Now for a product that I ended up really liking even after reviewing, and this is the Tarte Amazonian Clay 16-Hour Full Coverage Foundation. This is in the shade Medium Tan Neutral 36N. This is something that unfortunately I noticed a lot of people weren't a huge fan of, and to be really honest, I'm not sure why. Maybe I should go read those reviews, but at least for me, I ended up really liking it. I love how full coverage it is. It really does, a little bit of product goes a long way. I feel like it holds up really well for someone like me. I do have combination oily skin, and I just feel like it did pretty good. Like, I was really surprised and impressed with this formula, and I'm not a huge fan on the undertone to this foundation, but I definitely feel like it works. It works really well for me. And so I love this foundation. I'm not a huge fan of the fact that it's a squeezy tube. I really wish it had a pump, but overall I personally like it, and I can definitely see myself repurchasing that. Next is a product that I don't even feel like I should bring up because I think everyone's gonna know that I like this product, but I'm still gonna mention it. It is the Juvia's Place Eye Prep Eye Prime Eyeshadow Primer in the shade 2. Love the packaging, love the affordability of it. I absolutely love this eyeshadow primer. It is just so good. I love how easy it is to blend. You can use your finger, you can use a brush, you can use a sponge to blend out this product. A little tiny bit goes a long way. I used it today when I was getting ready, and I just personally love it. If you want to do a cut crease, you can definitely use this product. It will blend out really nicely. I just personally like it. It's not over drying, it's not sticky, it's not hard to remove this product from your eyes after you've, you know, done your makeup for the day. It's just really nice. So I personally really love it. So if you haven't tried this out, I highly suggest it. Now for benefit, the Earth Angel Fluoroscope Palette. I did a review video on this. I basically contoured, used the blush, the highlighters, and to be really honest, I love this palette. I have not touched Georgia after that video, but I have applied on Moon Honey and Cookie for sure. Cookie is my favorite. I love to actually apply this on all around my chest and shoulder area just because I feel like it gives you a beautiful glow from within and just makes your skin look really airbrushed, which I am obsessed with. I love to apply on Cookie. Honeymoon is really, really pretty. Love it. It blends out really nicely. It looks like a blush of color from within. As for the Hoola bronzer, I actually really like it, but I actually only like it with certain foundations. I've noticed that with certain other foundations, depending on the other undertones, I'm not a fan of how it looks on. So that is the only thing. So I'm really particular when it comes to wearing Hoola bronzer. But overall, I love how pigmented it is. It blends really nicely. Love the palette and love the price point for it. Another brow pencil that I reviewed here on my channel is the Too Faced Pomade in a Pencil Brow Sharper and Filler. The shade I picked up is in medium brown. It is dual end, so one end has a spoolie. The other end is our brow pencil. And the formula, you guys, is just so creamy. It was so easy for me to draw in my brows, and I just personally really liked it. I honestly feel like it is pigmented. I do feel like it's slightly the right undertone for me, but in a way, and I feel like in certain areas, it kind of looked a little light. So that is the only thing. I need something a little bit darker, but overall I feel like it works really well for me. I feel like if I change my hair color and go slightly blonder or warmer tone, this will work really well. I think next time I'll just pick up a darker brow pencil than this one, but overall I personally like it, and I can definitely see myself repurchasing this. The eyeshadow primer that I reviewed that I unfortunately ended up not being a fan of is the NYX Ultimate Shadow and Liner Primer. Again, I love the affordability, love the doe foot applicator. It picked up enough product. I love the application to it. Like, you apply it on and then it kind of blends out sheer. The consistency of it feels really moisturizing. It doesn't feel tacky. It's not hard to remove from your lids when you're washing your face after a long day. But to be really honest, if you want to do like a slight cut crease and kind of apply it on and then apply on another shadow, it's not going to do it for you. It's really not going to work. At least in my opinion, it didn't work out for me. And that is why this is something that I will not be reaching for again, just because this is very specific. I think this is perfect if we're going to do a simple eye. might just apply on one kind of look eyeshadow color on your lid, or maybe two or three, but you're not gonna go over and do like any type of crease or anything more, a little bit more graphic or a little bit more intricate. So that is the only reason why. As for another matte lipstick, this one is from Melt Cosmetics. This is from the Nudes Nudes collection. And I did a review video obviously on that. I don't even know why I keep mentioning that, because we all know that this whole thing is about review products mainly. But this is the lip shade Zaddy. Absolutely love the undertone to Zaddy. I've worn this so many times. I'm obsessed with the undertone to it, the creaminess of this formula. I will say though, the only thing with this, keep in mind that even for me, who I feel like I don't really deal with dry lips, and you guys know here on my channel, I always apply on the Winky Lips Luxe Lip Sleeping Mask on my lips to keep my lips nice and moisturized. This does feel a little drying to my lips, and I will say that it does cause little inner white lining in my mouth, which I'm not a huge fan of. This is something that I definitely wear, but I don't wear it alone. I tend to wear a gloss over it just to give it a little bit more of that shine and pout, and to give me a little bit of that moisture, and to kind of hopefully avoid the white inner lining that it leaves in my mouth after wearing it for some time. So that is the only thing. Love the packaging, love the graphic, the detail that they applied all around the rim of the lipstick, love the undertone to it, but unfortunately I'm not a huge fan of those little things that it causes. Last but not least is from Essence, and this is the Essence Baby Got Brow Eyebrow Pencil that is waterproof, really affordable. It's dual end, so one end has a spoolie, the other end is obviously our brow pencil. To be really honest, you guys, I reviewed this, and literally when I was editing that video, I noticed that my brows looked really, really red and undertone. I'm not a fan of that. I noticed that a lot of drugstore brow pencils tend to have that weird undertone, and I do not like it. It looks so unnatural, and I personally do not like it. I will not repurchase this again. I kept it just for this video, but yeah, I'm not a huge fan of it. It was really creamy, really easy to draw on my brows, but the undertone is just what got me, and I will not be repurchasing this. I almost forgot about this product, so let me share with you really quickly. This is the Patrick Star One Size Beauty Brow Kiki Medium Brown Shade Brow Pencil. And then I also picked up, obviously, and I reviewed it in the video, the Brow Kiki Clear Brow Gel. Let's start with the brow pencil. I actually really like it. I used it today. I love that it's pigmented, but it kind of gives you like a subtle brow. Like you can see them, but it's not gonna make my brows look super harsh. I ended up really liking it, and I'll continue using it. I can see myself repurchasing this, so I personally really love the formula. It doesn't fade throughout the day, the pigmentation or anything. It's just really easy, blends really nicely, and I personally love it. As for the brow gel, love the spoolie of it, love the packaging. I do find it to be pretty expensive for a clear brow gel, but that is not the reason why I wouldn't repurchase this. The reason is because it has a natural hold. It's not something that's going to really, you know, hold your brows into place for sure throughout the entire day. I think this is something you can apply on, and then, you know, throughout the day, if you have your hair parted in a certain way, like over the area where you've applied on the brow gel, kind of like me, how I part my hair to one side, you know, after so much friction throughout the day, they're gonna move naturally, and they're not gonna initially stay in one place. So it will not entirely hold everything into place, which is fine, at least for me. I'm not huge on that. It's not a big deal breaker. I will continue using this, but do I find the formula to be giving you a strong hold? No. Will I repurchase this? No, it's $21. I think that's a little too expensive for my taste. So, love the brow pencil, not a huge fan of the clear brow gel. All right, you guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video giving you updates on these products I have recently reviewed here on my channel. I hope you enjoyed this type of video. If you do, comment down below, let me know, like this video, let me know if you do, because maybe I can do this every month to give you more in-depth video on these products in case you're interested, you're still debating, you're not really sure. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Everything, of course, will be linked down below. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And as always, I will see you all in my next video. I love you all so much. Bye.